Welcome back to the second map of Miu against Insomnia. Still play day one of the Intel Extreme Masters season one. Still the Extreme Masters Intel Friday night game in Hamburg. And again, Miu starting with the altar first. This time spawning in the top left corner of Tarina stand. And Insomnia also starting with the altar first, spawning in the bottom right spawn position. So once again, nothing surprising from both of the players. And other than that, we'll see if Miu is gonna go for the same approach on TS as he did on Echo Ars. I'm assuming, like, I guess the fast expansion worked out very nicely for him previously, so why not do it again? But I'm assuming odds are that he's gonna go for the level 2 with these two camps first, but then again, who knows? Maybe we'll see a very quick expansion again. Again, Insomnia going for a scout farm here, while Miu is just keeping everything in his base, also not heading across the map to scout, which kind of tells us that he's planning to play his own game and that he wants to save as many resources as possible early on. Scout coming by Insomnia this time. First footmen are in production. Miu space wide open at two spots. Now it's only open at one. Now it's still open at two spot. Not two spots. Not quite as wide open here as it was before. Still open here as well. Actually, I think it's open here as well. So lots of openings in that base. While Insomnia space is only open here. And this might change with another farm eventually, either here or here, or maybe he's gonna keep it open. We'll find out. I mean, previously on Equas, he also had one gap in his wall, and it looks like both of the players this time are gonna start completely similarly, which is by creeping their goblin laboratories. Actually, they're not. Miu starts with a little apprentice wizard camp. Wants to save as much lumber as possible, apparently closing his base right now at the bottom. Now pulling militia. We'll see if he's gonna go for the lab still. No, he's actually not. So quite failed with my prediction there. Ring of protection for Insomnia. Miu only got slippers of agility. He starts with the goblin merchant, so apparently that's more important to him, having the items than having, you know, a reveal or an early shredder. And Mantle of Intelligence for Insomnia, so finally something that's useful to him. And Sentry Wards for Miu, very good item. I would have wished for Miu to find the Lightning Shield, just to see how he would use it, or if he would use it at all. And now he's gonna go for the fast expansion again. Lightning Shield onto one of the footmen, taking unnecessarily much damage here. Onto his own units, but now he's got it, you know, properly handled. Didn't finish a single creep with it so far. Now the rogue. Actually, I'm not quite sure. I think this may have been a lightning shield kill. Level 3 for the AM anyway. And Insomnia. This time he went for the mercenaries early on, like he did previously. He does find the big invul potion. 15 seconds of invulnerability for him if he wants to, and now they're gonna engage. I guess Insomnia would have liked to creep the level 3 here. Now he's gonna have to try and get it just by killing footmen. First one of Miu's footmen is gonna fall here. Dispel goes on one of the water mantles. AM is still surrounded and he's using his big invul potion, so I guess that's not how he wanted to use that that item, but still, in return, he already got two footmen killed as well as a water mantle, so this could have gone worse for Insomnia. And the footman sees the expansion this time. He's not gonna go for his own fast expansion, I was about to say, but still he doesn't tech. That's a bit surprising, very late tech by Insomnia, if he decides to not go for an expansion, which I'm assuming is gonna be the case. So now he's gonna have the resources soon, if he realizes it, because of course he's gonna be busy fighting as well. Miu trying to go for the surround on the AM. Insomnia successfully avoiding that surround. And this time he's going for the harassment, and this time he's doing plenty of damage, only Actually, all of the peasants have gone down. Some militia reinforcing already. One of them also has fallen already. He's soon gonna have another water elemental on the field. Only the AM is gonna have to be careful. And Mute, is he gonna let him escape? Insomnia doesn't wanna leave this fight right now because he could do so much damage to the peasants. I think he could have killed all of them again, but he's forced to town portal. Not what he wanted here, and shop is coming just now. I mean, he took plenty of damage. I guess when he was here, he shouldn't have moved into the back of this expansion. He should have just stayed here and, you know, attacked the peasants from a safe distance. So this wins Mio a lot of time to finally get his expansion up. I mean, he had to pull all his slumber peasant, and having six peasants in his gold mine certainly doesn't help him. Now he sees that and fixes it. AM 3.5 Subi mask, by the way, found at his natural expansion, which is of course great. Insomnia did get Clarity Potion as well as the Scroll of Regeneration, and he's heading out across the map again without the town portal this time, so he's gonna have to be much more careful. Tower coming as well as tier 2. Finally, he's about halfway through with that already. Water Metal being spawned, and Mew not falling for it here, going full front against Insomnia's army. He's gonna defend this little harassment. Footmen have to pull back. They're gonna go for the AM here at first, as it appears. Force Shadow Priest also with the army again to do some dispel. First off, Mew's Waterman has fallen already. Guess the AM here. Not that close to level 4. I expected him to be closer. Defend finished from Mew in the meantime, which is of course huge against both the Waterman and the Force Straw Berserker. And the Force Shadow Priest, but he doesn't do, you know, huge loads of damage anyway. So Mew looking fairly decent at the moment. He's getting one tower up, but at the same time, again, the three footmen are inside of Mew's expansion doing more harassment. And let's see how much damage he's actually gonna take from that. First of these footmen is about to fall. In the meantime, one of Mew's footmen up here has fallen as well, but the majority of Insomnia's army is being driven back. Another water metal of Insomnia is about to fall. He's not going, he's going for the deny, but too late. So the XP is going to Mew. Second footman of Insomnia is falling and didn't achieve all that much with that harassment. Arcane Tower is being upgraded right now. Of course, if that comes through, it's gonna be huge help against both the water metals and the AM. With, you know, working his way towards another water mantle, and right now he's finally got that, you know, serious XP lead that you'd expect him to have. By the way, Mew also started tier 2 already. Tier 2 finished for Insomnia. Two Arcane Sanctums are coming. Second tier with a Panda this time for Insomnia, but with a low HP footman in the middle, and he's gonna join the army. He's gonna try to keep the pressure up apparently. And yeah, he cancelled that Arcane Tower, very important, of course, also for the Panda to just enable him to cast Breath of Fire in there over and over again, but that's only gonna be the case if Mew is gonna let him get there, and for now he's gonna have to work through those footmen first. And for now Mew is standing strong. AM and Panda have to go back a little bit. Another Dispel going onto one of Mew's Water Elementals. With two Force Throw Shadow Priests, of course he's gonna be able to work against those very nicely. Force Throw Berserker is gonna have to be pulled back. And yeah, it's gonna be really, like, the timing of Insomnia is going to be when the first casters hit. Maybe he's gonna start with a couple of Zorks even in the beginning, since Mew doesn't have any Dispel around. Therefore, the slow is gonna be much more powerful, and that's exactly what we're seeing here. So these Zorks are the classic play, these Zorks at first. If the one base human player is trying to, you know, put as much pressure onto the two base human player with the tech disadvantage as possible. Guessing he's gonna wanna get a Scroll of Regeneration again. Maybe another Clarity. At least a Scroll of Regeneration here. And still keeping the ring, that's a bit surprising. I feel like he could sell it and get a Clarity, but he's getting the Clarity anyway. Water Mantle is in place here. Can he buy anything? I'm not sure about that. First two Zorks are now out on the field, and I'm assuming he's gonna wanna put up more pressure again. But Mew seems to be very much prepared for this. Three Guard Towers being upgraded here, and two of them are definitely gonna come up before Insomnia arrives, the third one as well, because Insomnia isn't gonna go for more pressure immediately. Water Metal just waiting here, is about to run out of duration, and we do see on the minimap there is a little, you know, streak of yellow or white units heading towards the top. So Insomnia is gonna go for the counter expansion right next to Mio's expansion, so he's willing, you know, to stay in touch with Mew right now, of course, because of the tech advantage, because of the 2 heroes against one, because of the slow against no slow. But Mew apparently is like, well, if you want to fight right now, then it's gonna be against a huge load of towers. And I don't think Insomnia is gonna be too excited about that. Mew completely blocking off this path for Insomnia. So basically, if he wants to, you know, head across Mew's side of the map, he's gonna have to take the long way around here and then also into the towers. So yeah, Mew making very, very nice use of the architecture of this map. Also 2 heroes for him. So yeah, kind of negates the use of that panda. This Breath of Fire, did it hit anything? I don't think so. So panda second for Mew as well. Tier 2 still for Insomnia. Expansion coming in. Mew with the perfect timing. Again, he's gonna be able to do plenty of damage here. The army is coming in right now. Blizzard by Mew, and he's gonna be able to cancel that expansion. Defense used once again as well. And I'm assuming he's probably not gonna fight here. Or is he? Blizzard coming in again against the casters of Insomnia. He's gonna have to reposition. Of course, Blizzard plus Breath of Fire is gonna do a lot of AoE damage to these units. And yeah, that really is a lot of damage. Footman going down, Forest Troll Shadow Priest going down. Another Blizzard coming in. Actually, Mew is looking a lot stronger in this fight already than I expected, even though he only has Footman and his 2 heroes. Next Breath of Fire is coming in. And actually, it is Insomnia who's forced to pull back here. The Water Metals actually not doing anything against the defense footman. One arcane tower is about to finish soon. He's trying to go for the surround on the panda, but with slow defense footman, you know, you're not very likely to get the surrounds closed. And Mew with only these footmen, I mean, these are throwaway units, of course, he's able to win enough time to cancel the town hall of Insomnia again. And this is just looking great for Mew once again. He's getting towards Tier 3, once again, two arcane, Griffin aviaries coming. Not sure about this expansion, but let's just first take a look at how much peasants he's gonna be able to kill. There are 4 remaining for Insomnia at the moment here, at the top of the map. 3 are remaining, he's gonna be forced to town portal right now. There's no more mana on the panda. So he's not gonna get any more footmen killed. Maybe the sorcerers, no, not even the sorcerers, but still a very successful push by Mew. 38 supply for Insomnia against 46 from Mew, plus tons of towers at his expansion, plus tech advantage. Yeah, this time we're not seeing any arcane sanctums at all for Mew. But still, he's got the tech advantage. So, if he's just getting enough tier 3 units on the field, he's gonna look just fine, even without casters. Blacksmith now coming. Of course, he needs that for the knights, as well as the animal war training upgrade, which is gonna be essential even if he just produces units only from the griffin aviaries. But since there are only 2 griffin aviaries, I don't think we're gonna see only griffins. Job I done. Guess griffins knights. Job done. Or he's gonna add workshops, could be the case as well. And he's just gonna keep the pressure up here, maybe some blizzard in here. Arcane Tower is already attacking the AM. Dragon Haze, Breath of Fire, Blizzard doing so much damage. 1 peasant going down, 2, I guess 3, 4 are probably going to die in total. Actually, I'm getting 2 so far. Bit surprised about that, I guess. The Breath was maybe still on cooldown. Now he doesn't have the mana anymore to use another one. So Mew is going to be forced to Town Portal here sooner or later. Now the Blizzard coming in actually gets 2 more peasants killed. Insomnia a little bit overeager with him putting his peasants back into the gold mine very soon. At the same time, some harassment by the footman of Mew again, but Insomnia splitting his army nicely, keeping his casters at the top to defend against footman, and of course slowed footman against 8 casters, if I counted correctly, aren't gonna do too much. 8 casters plus the arcane tower, but that one isn't gonna make too much of a difference. It's hammer time. Yeah, first griffin is out, nothing in the blacksmith. Okay, and there are 2 workshops, so that's what we're gonna see. Even the third one. Level 5 again for Insomnia's AM. So kinda like on the first map here. I mean, the first map was already over at this time. But kinda like on the first map, Insomnia's got a very strong AM. Mew this time doesn't have a very strong second hero compared to Insomnia. But maybe he's gonna get there, creeping the Goblin Lab alone right now, AM. Ah, okay, he was stuck in the back of his base, apparently killing one of his own towers. Still don't... Yeah, I guess this might be open here. Anyways, the workshops are coming through. Panda's still not level 3. He's got the Staff of Sanctuary already. Ah, okay, I guess he TP'd in front and then he staffed his AM. And then it got into the back. That's why the rest of the army wasn't stuck. And what's Insomnia doing? He's still staying tier 2. And he's getting flying machines. But the problem is the splash upgrade for the flying machines, the flak cannons upgrade, is tier 3. And therefore, tier 2 flying machines are just so much worse than tier 3 flying machines. But it looks like that's gonna be the unit he's gonna put his trust in to counter Mio's Griffins. Let's see how much he actually saw here. Looks like he already saw one Griffin aviary producing, so he knows that it's probably gonna be a lot of Griffins again for Mio. Yeah, there are 5 flying machines out by now. At the same time, level 3 for Mew's Panda already, which of course is also great against the flying machines. And what's he getting? Stormhammer's upgrade. And flying machines as well, but he's getting the flak cannons upgrade because he is tier 3, so his flying machines are going to be a lot more valuable than Insomnia's flying machines. And is Insomnia actually willing to take a fight here? I mean, he's at 60 supply, he spent all his gold. Whereas Mew is at 77 supply, also spent all his gold. 1-0 upgrades, by the way, on the Griffins. He's got the Stormhammer's upgrade right now. He's got the first attack upgrade for his flying machines that just finished, as we see down here. And he's got the Animal War Training upgrade by now as well. So he's looking very much prepared. Maybe a third hero could be produced by Mew. Decides not to do so. I guess the Paladin would be the obvious choice. And actually, Mew falling back for now. Maybe wants to get an invo potion, maybe a heal scroll here. Or just more units. I guess there's not really a point in going over 80 supply overly quickly for him. So yeah, he's getting a heal scroll. And maybe waiting for 150. Okay, selling even more. So he's getting a second heal scroll here already. Which is of course going to be of huge help for his Griffins against both Flying Machines and the Panda. But then again, the Flying Machines don't even have AoE. He's getting to tier 3, or he's trying to get to tier 3 right now. I guess Mew would, you know, it would be good for Mew if he took a fight before Flak Cannons gets finished for Insomnia. Because then these Flying Machines are going to be very good against Mew's Griffins. But then again, taking down his opponent's entire economy is going to be quite big for Mew. So economy advantage for him again. Panda also level 3 finally for Insomnia. He's got a protection scroll. Okay. I mean, Insomnia, the one thing he's got going for him is that he's got a couple of casters, so he's at least going to be able to slow the Griffins. But still, Mew is doing so well here, taking down another bunch of economy off his opponent. Let's see if he's gonna take the fight right now. I'm assuming he should, even though that's a huge load of flying machines. But Mew sees that the tier 3 has just finished right now. And Breath of Fire is coming in, hitting perfectly. The flying machines of Insomnia are not microed properly, pulling back. Blizzard is coming in, all the flying machines are going down. It's 46 supply against 77 still for Mew, who barely lost anything here. Blizzard coming in against the casters. A panda of Mew is taking a bit of damage, needs to be careful, but he still has the heal potion, so he should be fine. Another Blizzard is coming in against the AM. Panda still has the heal potion, he's gotta use that one right now. There's the staff on Mew's AM, so the panda should survive. The best Insomnia can achieve here is to force him out of the fight. And Insomnia has dropped to 22 supply right now, losing more or less everything. The panda has been staffed, and Insomnia calls the GG. What a destruction by Mew, 2-0 against Insomnia. Of course, Mew probably pushed by, you know, the viewers in Hamburg, of course, even close to where he grew up, I think. But still, that shouldn't be enough to, you know, dominate one of the best humans in Europe like he just did. In both maps, completely outplayed him, in my opinion. I guess Insomnia did a fair amount of damage. I think I mentioned it within the game, he would have been able to do so much more damage, delay the expansion even more, if he didn't get his AM stuck in the back of Mew's expansion. And then afterwards, I guess his timing wouldn't have worked out, you know, wouldn't have completely worked out, because the three guard towers were about to finish. But then again, he tagged so late, that's what I also mentioned during his harassment. If he tagged earlier, he would have had sorceresses, say, 20 seconds earlier, easily, and then he could have started pushing, then he could have cancelled those towers, and I think then the game can go completely differently, because Mew had nothing in place, basically, say, when those towers were only starting to be upgraded. And afterwards, the counter expansion, very nicely countered by Mew. I didn't expect him to crush Insomnia like he did, or, well, not crush, but to do so well against Insomnia in the fight when he only had Defend Footman and Blizzard and Breath of Fire, but he was able to cancel the expansion over and over again, and then he just had the economy advantage and took it home very safely. So that finishes Group D on play day one. Mew being at the top here of the Group D together with Lilycee and Titan, all of them winning 2-0, so yeah, not all that close best of threes in Group D. Yeah, gonna do a little recap next of the entire first play day, and tell me what you thought about this best of three, about Group D in general, and then we're gonna continue with play day two with Group A again, with Deadman against Firestrike. And yeah, Deadman didn't really get, you know, too much time to shine in his first best of three. Maybe he's going to do better against Firestrike. And that's all for now. I'll see you. Bye.